You saw me standing alone without a dream in my heart, without a love of my own.
What's up, guys? Or should I say, what's up, Pack? Tonight is a little special. Tonight is the first blue moon that I can remember. So, naturally, this vlog will be titled Once in a Blue Moon. And I'm gonna fucking go home and drink some blue moons. That's kind of the theme now, if you haven't guessed. I figured I would tell a story once in a blue moon that I would never usually talk about. And I figured nothing's better than childhood stories. And since this is a motovlogging channel, might as well be something about motorbikes. The last picture that I showed you was my very first mini bike. I had that till probably I was 4 or 5, and then I got lost in storage. I had a lot of like little 50 bikes throughout my life. Man, I almost forgot about some of those. I had two Hondas, and then I went to my little Yamaha that I used to ride out in the desert every once in a while, but it didn't work for shit. It always died and stuff on me. But I used to keep it in my dad's workshop, and every time I'd go, I'd look at it and be, you know, just kind of wish I could ride it, because there'd be nothing to do at the shop, and it's so boring. And then just one day, like this one like magical perfect day, I was sitting on it and just kind of dreaming, and then out of nowhere, I got the feeling just to kick it over. I kicked that bitch over, started first kick, like a miracle. I almost fucking shit myself. I think I was about 13, nah, maybe a little younger. Nah, yeah, I was about 13. Nah, way younger. I was about 8. Yeah, I was about 8 sitting on this teeny little fucking bike. And it's all yellow and out of little crappy plastics and stuff. And I don't even know what ever happened to that bike. I think that got lost in storage too. But I kicked it over. That little thing fired up. It backfired. Huge cloud of smoke came out of it. My dad comes running out and he's like, it started? I was like, just a shock, nodding my head. And he's like, he runs to the back of the shop, grabs my helmet, plops it on my head, and he's like, go, just go. I must have rode that bitch till it ran out of gas. I didn't stop riding for like 2.5 hours. Like, and there wasn't a lot of area to go. It was seriously just a little parking lot, and there was some dirt over by the train tracks that I kind of rode in, and I just rode it and rode it and rode it. I made sure not to let it die either. And then, after my long day of it, and it's awesome fun, I turned, I parked it, hit the kill switch, got off aching and sweaty and just super happy, and that was the last time it ever ran. And then we ended up getting a Honda 250 four-stroke. It was like an 05 from a friend. Probably a stolen bike. Pretty sure it was a stolen bike now that I think about it. And yeah, that bike was so big for me. I was short as fuck. I could like get 1 foot down when I stopped, and I would ride that thing everywhere. And one day I got the balls to start jumping it. Like, it started off little, wasn't even a jump, and it just got more like higher and higher and higher until I was basically jumping off like a little sandbank, you know, where quads turn in the sand and it makes like a little half wall. I was jumping up out of that, and I got good enough to start taking my feet off, and then I was taking my hand off, and I was probably getting, I don't know, a good 5 feet off the ground, which isn't that high at all for a dirt bike. And where we used to go out riding, there was a lot of like big ass MX jumps. And I'd always look at them and be like, I know I could jump that fucking thing. I never did because it was too scary, because they were like 6 foot tall, like fucking motocross jumps for backflips and shit. And yeah, I never did that. One time too, I was just out riding and I decided to open it up and like the dirt I'm on was mixed between sand and like hard gravel, like off and on. And I was fucking just gunning this, but I don't know what they top out at. I want to say close to 90 or 85-ish, like pretty close. And that's fast as fuck on dirt when you're a little kid. I was probably like 17. I hit this sand patch and just dumped it. Like it fucking hit the ground. I rolled off the bike, like it hit it. Okay, so the front tire slid, so I low sided it. I fell off the bike. The bike slid and then flipped over onto the other side once it hit more sand. And this other rider saw me, and he's like, oh shit, are you okay? So he helped me, his camp was like a couple of feet away, so he helped me push the bike back to camp, and they gave me some water and stuff, and it was so awkward, like I didn't want to be there at all. And then out of nowhere, I'm just like, well, I'm, because I didn't get hurt at all, I was fine, I just wanted to get some water. And then I'm like, well, I'm okay, so I jump back up on the bike and start to kickstart it, and I was so exhausted that I fucking fell over again. They're like, oh, are you sure you're okay? I'm just trying to play it off because I want to get the hell out of there. I was just feeling awkward. And then I finally got a kickstart and just rode off and went back home. And then later with that 250 is where I got my neck injury of why my back is like so fucked up. Like parts of my spine are just like crooked. I never went to a chiropractor or anything. I don't have the money for that shit. So I'm riding it's basically a quad track at like an actual track that you pay to get into. And it's a decent little track. It ain't have nothing huge or anything like that. And I started getting comfortable on it, taking it pretty quick, and there was this one little jump where it's a jump and then it's like a big hill that drops down, so you're not really jumping, you're kind of just jumping out and falling. I was getting ready to speed up because to go around a corner to speed up and hit it to go higher, and in that corner there was fucking the only place in the track that had mud. So just like in the sand, the front tire hit the mud and I lost it because like this bike's way too fucking big for me. And I lost the control. And instead of it going sideways, the tire kind of stuck and dumped me over. It like, endowed, and I landed right on my neck. And I don't think I had a concussion or anything. Oh, my neck hurts so bad. And then later come to find out that, yeah, I twisted two sections of the vertebrae and I don't have money to fix it. And I think it'd take a lot of, chiropractics to get it straight. That is my long ass ramble on Once in a Blue Moon, guys. I don't even know if that ties together and makes sense. These are stories that I don't ever really talk about or have plans to talk about. So there's the Blue Moon. If you guys don't know what a blue moon is, the blue moon is a second full moon in 1 month. And we just happen to have it this year. That's what the saying is, once in a blue moon, because it's kind of rare. But that is all the time I have. Thank you for watching, and welcome to the pack, everyone that has subscribed. You'll see me in the next one.
But keep the price real low. So that link will be in here. Here's a picture of the shirt I'm making. I'll put a little link to the Teespringy campaigny thingamajigs down there. This is the first time I've ever done that. So if you guys want a t-shirt, that's where to get them.